So why don't we walk through our solution here? First, we initialize this variable m, which we say is equal to length of values. So we're basically saying here, hey, this is how many data points we have. We also initialize this variable called cost history, which is going to track how our cost function evolves over our iterations. We say for I in range num iterations, which basically says, hey, we're going to update theta and the cost a number of times equal to the number of iterations, let's calculate the predicted values. We'll do that by taking the dot product of the features and theta. Then we're going to update our values of theta. This looks pretty complicated, but you'll note that it's the same as the equation that we just discussed, which we'll pull up again here. So we subtract our observed values from our predicted values, take the dot product of this vector with the features, and then essentially multiply by this alpha over m feature and subtract that from theta. This is effectively gradient descent in action. So we're taking a very small step in the direction of the steepest gradient. Then we're going to use another function called compute cost, which we see up here, to compute the cost function given our features, our values, and our theta. Then we'll append the newest cost to the cost history list. And once we've done this a number of times equal to the number of iterations, we'll not only return our final set of thetas, but also the entire cost history. You'll see that if we run this function, we get this array, which are our theta values, about 45, minus 9, and 13. And these values kind of indicate how significant each factor is in determining our predicted values. So this 45 corresponds to a constant term, the minus 9 corresponds to height, and the 13 and change corresponds to the weight. And then we see here how the cost function has evolved over time. Ideally, if we had a perfect model, this cost function would approach zero. You'll see that our cost function doesn't, you know, get close to zero. It does decrease a good amount as we train this model, but it doesn't do super well. And so this might lead you logically to a natural question, which is, hey, you know, not all models are created equal. Maybe our model is actually bad. Is there some way that we can evaluate our models? Why don't we discuss this a little bit more?